What happens if we have many legacy files from older versions of CorelDRAW? Well, luckily, CorelDRAW includes a script called the file converter, which can take a whole group of files from a source folder, convert them into another format, or another CorelDRAW version, and save these to a new destination folder. Let's take a look at this now. Before I commence with batch converting files, I normally start by creating a destination folder for the converted documents. If you're planning to convert a folder of files into more than one format, for example, converting files into the latest CorelDRAW format, and also converting them into EPS, CMX, or PDF files, then I would personally create a folder for each format. The file converter script can be found under Tools, Scripts, Run Script. Select the file converter from the macros in drop-down list and click Run. I start by choosing the folder containing my legacy files, and this time, we'll go with CorelDRAW X4 files. Add individual files or all files to the selected files list. As the destination folder, I'll choose the converted files folder I created earlier. Now I need to decide which file format I want to convert to. Some of the chosen formats, such as AI or EPS for example, offer advanced settings, so be sure to check those out. In our case, I just want to convert the X4 files up from version 14 to 24. You'll notice also that we have the option to save multi-page files as separate documents. We can also embed color profiles. And if we know we'll have font issues due to missing fonts or font replacement, but we want to keep the appearance of our text, we can choose to convert the text to curves. We also have further options here below. If my documents include bitmaps, I can change the resolution here, apply anti-aliasing, or adjust any of the other settings. As a tip, if you are converting documents that contain shapes or logos in bitmap format, and you're planning perhaps to convert these to vectors, then leave out the anti-aliasing, as this will only introduce more colors and nodes into your final traced image. Once we've converted our files up to the current version, we can then go ahead and edit them in CorelDRAW.